and all, my name is Rio and welcome to another match day vlog. Today Chester FC make the journey to Yorkshire as we play York City away in a big showdown between two promotion chasing sides. So we do need to get to the points today because we desperately need them as the chasing pack such as Brackley Town, Darlington and of course Boston United are just behind us, so we do need to try and make some daylight today between us and them. So it is a massive game today for both teams. So of course I do hope you enjoy today's video. If so, please like, subscribe and comment down your thoughts of the game below. So let's get into today's video right now. Enjoy. It is important that we do take advantage of York's recent stutter as they have lost at home to fellow playoff rivals Guiseley and Darlington, so we do need to take advantage today because the other night in Gateshead we did miss a huge opportunity, so it is necessary that we do get something today, otherwise we will continue to slip away, which is what we don't need whatsoever. So in the reverse fixture back in October we gave York far too much respect at home, so today what we do need to do is try and revert to playing the ball on the ground, because in the second half in particular all we actually did was just hoof the ball up, which never worked at all, and Steve McNulty had an absolute field day for York. So what we do need to do is today man mark Steve and play the ball on the ground, which will give us a better chance of getting something, otherwise York will punish us. So our last match was on Tuesday night as we lost 2-0 away at Gateshead in what was a really miserable night for us once again, just like it was in the North East a few weeks earlier at Darlington. So it was quite a poor, unacceptable performance by us. So today we do need to do loads better. So to be fair, the first half was actually okay by us. For the first 15 minutes of the game in particular, we were by far the better team because we played some nice stuff on the ground and we did have some good chances too, especially John Johnston, who was involved a lot in the opening stages. However, the second half was a different story because we just reverted to sitting back way too deep. Our tactics were so negative and we invited loads of pressure by Gateshead. So Gateshead were all over us and we deservedly came out as second best. So we simply cannot do that today, otherwise York will have a field day. So 20 minutes into the second half, Jordan Preston made it 1-0 to Gateshead. So he scored on the edge of the area. He curled the ball into the far right-hand corner. So defensively, we should have done loads better because we gave him far too much space. Also, a few minutes later, 10 minutes later to be precise, Gateshead made it 2-0. So debutant Rory Keating, who used to play for Torquay United, made it 2-0 to Gateshead. So the corner went in and all he had to do was score a simple header from a matter of yards out. So again, really poor defending by us. We should have easily just booted the ball away, but again, we did really poorly. So today, we do need to do a lot more, otherwise it will be a long afternoon for us. So you can watch both of the goals from Gateshead in my matchday preview, which was out yesterday. It will take about 2 hours to get to York from here, so it will be quite a nice short journey. So I have been to York once before, which was 4 years ago, back in 2016, where we drew 1-1 away thanks to a last gasp injury time equalising goal by Kane Richard. So more of the same today would be very nice indeed. So York City play at Bootham Crescent, which holds 8,256, so it is a really nice old fashioned classic historical stadium with a lot of character. However, as you all may know, sadly York are moving to a new stadium in the near future, so sadly in the coming weeks and months Bootham Crescent will be demolished, which will be quite sad to see. But thankfully, I have been there before, and today it will be our last ever visit to Bootham Crescent. So, on one side is the main stand, which is a covered all-seater affair, which has a bit of a two halves to it. So the first half is towards the back of the stand, where there is quite a old benching area, which goes to show that Bootham Crescent does have a lot of character to it. Meanwhile, the other half is towards the front of the stand, which consists of modern seats. Also, there are a few supporting pillars which will affect your view. Opposite to main stand is the popular side, which is another covered all-seater stand with supporting pillars which will affect your view. Behind one goal is the David Longhurst stand, which is a covered terrace with a lot of rows of terracing. It has about 5 rows of terracing, so the York City fans will make a fantastic atmosphere today, and hopefully so will we. And also, once again, it does have some supporting pillars which will hinder your view. Lastly, behind the other goal is the Prostate Cancer UK stand, which is a uncovered terrace. So today's match is going to be segregated, so we will be allocated the Prostate Cancer UK stand and also 1/6 of the popular side as well. So we will be taking a bumper crowd today, I'd say around the 700th mark, which so hopefully we can sing the blues to victory, because our support will have to count for everything today. York City have had an unsurprising season so far, as they have spent most of the season in the top two, as they have a really strong budget there, and they have signed impressive players such as Andy Bond, Elliot Durrell, and of course Steve McNulty. However, that hasn't been enough for the Minster men, as they sit in second place behind Kingsland Town, who seem to be running away with the league as we speak, so York might have to go up through the hard way via the playoffs if things keep on going. So York started off the season in fantastic fashion, as they started off on fire, because it took until November for their first ever defeat, which was away at Curzon Ashton, which was a major shock, as Curzon were near the bottom. However, since then, York have slipped away, as 3 further defeats, especially against the likes of Darlington and Guiseley, has saw them consolidate in second place. So I don't think York will win the league this season, because Kingsland have some sort of consistency, which is what the likes of us and York don't have. So I think Kingsland will win the league, but we will just have to wait and see, I do suppose. Also, there will be 2 former Chester FC players up against us today, who are Andy Bond and Elliot Durrell. So, first of all, centre midfielder Andy was here back in 2014, where he made a few appearances. He signed for York a few months ago, back in the summer, from AFC Fylde, and he has been a regular starter for York. Meanwhile, right winger Elliot was here between 2016 and 2017, where he was foolishly released by John McCarthy in farcical circumstances. He signs for Macclesfield Town, where he was their key player for 2 years in Sky Bet's League 2, before signing for York a few months ago, back in September. So he hasn't really played too many games for York, but he did score a few weeks ago against his former club, AFC Telford United. So I do think Elliot will play today, and he will be a key outlet for them. All you do is call me. We have played against York City 5 times before, and we are yet to win a single game, so we do need to make it count today, otherwise it will be a disaster. So, our last match against York was back on October the 26th, 2019, which was a narrow 1-0 home defeat. So as I said before, we gave York too much respect that day. There wasn't really much in the game, but York delivered when it really mattered. So I think today's game will be quite close once again, and we do need to deliver. My score prediction for today's game is York City 0, Chester FC 1. So for Chester, I think Anthony Dudley will score for us today. So I think it will be quite a close, tight affair once again, with both sides cancelling each other out. However, I think we will strike in the dying moments of the game to record a memorable win. So hopefully, come 5 o'clock tonight, I will be right, and we will singing all the way back to Chester. As usual, I will be going today, so look out for my match day vlog, which will be coming up right now, so stay tuned. So, of course, I can't wait for the game today. I hope you enjoy it. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment down your thoughts of the game below. So what a massive game it is going to be today. A really, really strong following behind the Blues today, and we do need to make it count. So I've been waiting for ages for this game. I've been looking forward to it for months now. Cannot wait. Come on, you Blues. We need to do it now. Come on. Going up and down, all around the bends. You could have I have just arrived at Bootham Crescent ready for today's game. So it is a huge game for both teams, both at the top of the table, because York will be hoping to keep the pressure on Kingsland Town at the top, and also we will be hopeful of cementing our place in the top three, hopefully. So we have been dealt with two big boosts ahead of today's game, which will give us a lot of confidence, as both George Glendon and of course Brad Jackson have signed new deals. So hopefully both of them will be in our team today, alongside John Johnson of course, who signed a couple of weeks ago. So what a massive game it is today. Should be a cracking atmosphere, and yeah, cannot wait for it now. Come on, you Blues. Here is your York City squad for today's game, and here is your Chester FC squad for today's game. We are in a 4-5-1 formation, so in goal is number 1 Russ Griffiths, in defence is 2 Jamie Morgan, 5 Danny Livesey, 6 Simon Grand and 3 Joel Taylor. In midfield is 7 Brad Jackson, 4 captain Scott Burton, 8 George Glendon, 11 Alton Nguitala and 10 John Johnston. And up front is 12 James Jones, 14 Kevin Roberts, 15 Gary Stopforth, 16 Gary Roberts and 17 Anthony Dudley. So enjoy the vlog. Come on, City.
Chester FC! Da la la la!
York City, one, Chester FC nil, a very similar goal to the one Rory Keating scored the other day. Corner went in at the back post and another header went in. Disastrous start. What a superb goal by Jamie Morgan, a counter-attack goal, and he's slotted into the left-hand corner, 1-0 now, game on. Gone in. Oh, a bit too high for the back post, and York kill it away.
We'll sing on our own. We'll sing on our own. Winchester FC. We'll sing on our own.
York City 2, Chester FC 1, my words, we are awful at defending corners. Another corner went in, we just couldn't head it away at all, and York got to the second ball and another simple goal. Awful defending again. Sing when you win it, you only sing when you win it. York City have just scored disallowed goal, so thankfully the flag was raised, otherwise it would be 3-1. We now have another corner on the left-hand side as York headed away, so I think it's John Johnson who's taken it. It's gone to the back! Oh! I think it was a header by Danny Lipsy, which went wide. One! Oh! Oh! Unlucky! Unlucky by Brad Jackson. He did really well to catch the ball on the volley, but the York keep made a decent save. York City 3, Chester FC 1, way too easy once again. Terrible defending because the cross went in and all the York player had to do was tap in at the back post. Defensively, we have been shocking, both today and on Tuesday. half-time, York City 3, Chester FC 1. So the first half has been simply shocking by us. We have a massive mountain to climb because York have been by far better than us and we have barely done anything at all other than a decent equaliser by Jamie Morgan. So first of all, Sean Newton made it 1-0 to York City. A corner went in and all he had to do was head home. All three of the goals have been so similar to against us on Tuesday night. Awful defending, and second half we had to do loads better. However, we actually made it 1-1 as Jamie Morgan scored a fantastic goal to make it 1-1. He ran with the ball then he slotted into the far left-hand corner to make it 1-1. Since then, though, York have been by far better than us because, again, we conceded two really soft defensive goals. So the next one was scored by Kieran Green to make it 2-1 to York City. Another corner went in and we failed to get the ball away. And all Kieran had to do was head in. And lastly, York City made it 3-1 before half-time, as it was debutant Kurt Willoughby who slotted in to make it 3-1. So we need to do loads more now in the second half. Come on, you. City 4, Chester FC 2, yet another poor defensive goal to concede. The cross went in and the York player headed across the face of goal. Defensively today we have been shocking. Come on, Jonah! Oh, James Jones. Come on, no! James Jones tried to get the ball in but York clear away for a throw in. To make a bad afternoon even worse, Jamie Morgan has just been sent off for us. He's just got his second yellow card of the game, so it's effectively game over now. Joel Taylor has been pushed over, so the free kick's gone in by Asante, and York head it away. Come on, Dudes! It's gone to Dudley in the penalty area. Back to Jones. Oh, Asante gets the header, but it's way too wide. Full-time York City 4, Chester FC 2. Really, really awful once again today. We simply can't complain about that because defensively, an absolute horror show once again. So another massive opportunity missed. More reaction shortly. York City 4, Chester FC 2. So once again we have lost for the second consecutive game against fellow playoff rivals, which is rather concerning in my opinion, because we just never turn up to big games, and once again we failed to today. Defensively, we were tragic as we conceded 4 really soft goals, which does need sorting out ASAP. The 2 goals we conceded at Gateshead on Tuesday night were preventable, especially their second, which was a free header from a corner. I did expect us to cut those mistakes out today, but we never, which brings great disappointment and, of course, frustration. We simply cannot make a single excuse about today because we were beaten by the better side and have only ourselves to blame. The actual match itself was action-packed as there was plenty of drama, but sadly our poor showing has taken the gloss out of that. As much as it does pain me to say it, York City were by far the better team today and deservedly won because they took advantage of our silly errors and has lots of confidence behind them. For us though, we have missed another opportunity to take points off our playoff rivals for the second consecutive game as we now dropped a place to 4th. The margins are so tight now and we are far from secure as only 4 points separate us from 8th, so we really do need to pull our socks up now, and hopefully today is a major, major wake-up call. There were certainly plenty of talking points in the first period, but on the whole, it was one to forget for us as we trailed by an emphatic scoreline at the interval. It was the hosts who came out of the blocks earlier than us as they moved the ball around quickly and pressed us really well. We failed to get going as we were shaky at the back, and whenever we had the ball, we lacked any ideas. New signing Kurt Willoughby was immediately involved for York City in the opening minute, as he scooped over from a corner to give us a warning sign. In the 4th minute, we foreshadowed what was to come as the first of a few nervy moments arrived, as a mix-up between Russ Griffiths and Simon Grant resulted in Willoughby firing over. Our slow start turned into reality before the 10th minute mark, as Sean Newton headed in from a corner to make it 1-0 to York City, similar to Rory Keating's goal for Gateshead on Tuesday. To our credit though, we responded really well as Jamie Morgan bagged a superb goal for us to make it 1-1. We went on a brilliant counter-attack as Akwasi Asante raced the ball up the pitch to Morgan, who cut inside to fire into the far left-hand corner to put us right back into contest. In midfield, we weren't too bad after our equaliser because we did make some good moves and passed the ball around quite well. However, our defensive issues were still evident, as halfway through the half, York City retook the lead to make it 2-1. Our attempt of clearing the ball away wouldn't look out of place on a comedic sketch, as we headed the ball about 5 times, only for it to remain in the penalty area, which saw Kieran Green picking up the pieces with a powerful header into the near corner. 5 minutes later, York City thought they increased their advantage, but thankfully, Jordan Burrow's goal was disallowed for offside. We did show some glimpses of promise on the ball, as we did actually play some decent stuff in possession, but our inaccurate crosses was our major downfall today, as the majority of them were either blocked or went wide. At the other end, Burrow was involved again for York, as a weak header by him was straight at Griffiths. Also at the other end, once again, Braz Jackson had a decent opportunity for us in front of the home faithful, as he did really well to catch the ball on the volley, but Pete Jameson got down well to deny him. Seconds later, Joel Taylor had lashed a hit miles over, but things got from bad to worse at the other end, as Kurt Willoughby made it 3-1 to York City. Once again, it was an easy goal to concede, as Green's cross went in towards Willoughby, who simply tapped in at the back post. We had a huge mountain to climb going into the second 45, as we made things very hard for ourselves in a really, really inept first half. The second half was less frantic, but we still offered very little up top, and on the wings we continued with our poor deliveries. Less than 10 minutes into the second period, George Glendon gave us a lifeline to make it 3-2, as he capitalised on a poor York City clearance to smash in. On the hour mark though, we received another sucker punch as Kurt Willoughby netted his second of the game to make it 4-2 to York City. The cross by Sean Newton went in, which saw Kurt head across the face of goal, whilst at the same time we backed off and failed to clear the ball away. To cap off a forgettable day at the office, Jamie Morgan got sent off for us by picking up his second booking, which came to great shame considering he scored a lovely goal in the first half. York's dominance continued as Willoughby was denied by Russ Griffiths, whilst Dan Maguire went close to adding further misery to us as he slotted past the post. With time ticking, Akwasi Asante was unable to grab a consolation as he lashed over following a long Joel Taylor throw. We never got one, and overall we were simply not good enough, as we deservedly recorded our first back-to-back defeat of the season. So prior to today's game, I did say that I did want George Glendon to start, and fair play to our managers for picking him. I don't agree with some of their other choices, but George plays relatively well, so I will opt for him as my man of the match. He was involved a lot on the ball, made a couple of nice moves, and pulled the goal back for us, although it is just a shame that we never kicked on from there. Also, Alton Agüitala made his first start for a while, and he didn't really have a bad game because he was sharp, just like he was on Tuesday at Gateshead when he came on. However, I am struggling to pick out many more positives really, because on the flip side, De Beers are mostly lies with our defence. Simon Grant had his worst game in a while today because his tracking back was poor, his headers went all over the place, and he gave the ball away too many times. Russ Griffiths has been very solid lately, but today and on Tuesday, he brought back memories of early on in the season where he had very nervy moments. He was hesitant again today because he rarely went off his line for corners or crosses, which is one of the key aspects in goalkeeping. Something needs to be worked on in training because we simply cannot afford to have him making the same mistakes over and over again, because other than that, he is quite a good shot stopper. Also, Scott Burton was pretty poor today too, and I don't understand why we've thrown him straight into a huge game when he has been absent for months. I personally would have played Gary Roberts in place of him and instead make Burton start next week against lesser opponents. He just didn't do enough for me to impress me today because he was a bit too slow, and on the ball, he gave it away a tad too much as well. Our next match is on Saturday as we play Blyth Spartans at home, where we simply have to bounce back. We have recorded back-to-back defeats for the first time this season, so I will be very interested to see how we do respond. Blyth are fighting for their lives at the other end of the table, so we must not underestimate them, otherwise we could be in for another Curzon Ashton. Hopefully though, we will be on our game, because on our day we can easily blitz anyone at home. As usual, I will be going to the game on Saturday, so look out for a matchday preview, which will be out on Friday, and of course on Saturday I will do a vlog of the game as well. So of course I do hope you enjoyed today's matchday vlog. If so, please like, subscribe and comment down your thoughts of the game below.